So we are to solve this question. We are to find x given this angle to be 2s degree, this angle to be 60 degrees, and this angle to be s degrees. Now the solution of this one is very simple. Why? Because you can see that you are having a cyclic quadrilateral here. This is one line, one line, two line, three line, four. This is cyclic quadrilateral, and this angle here is an exterior angle to this cyclic quadrilateral. Also, this angle here, 60 degrees, also an exterior angle to this opposite interior angle rather. So this angle here is exterior angle to this opposite interior angle. So from there, that means the theorem will prove that exterior angle of cyclic quadrilateral is equal to opposite interior angle. That means these two, which is interior angle, is equal to this opposite exterior angle, this angle here that is here. So that means these two s degree and this angle here are the same thing. So that means this angle here is going to be what? 2s degrees. Now we're having angle BCE. Where is BCE? This angle that is here is what? 2s degrees. Why? Exterior angle is equal to opposite interior angles of a cyclic quadrilateral. So from this triangle BCE now, if you have this angle to be 60 degrees, this angle to be 2s degrees, and this angle to be s degree. If you had all these three angles together, because this is a triangle, it should give us 180 degrees. Reason, sum of angle in a triangle. And that should be the case. What is 2s plus x? That'll give us 3x. If I collect light and take this 60 to the other side, we have 180 minus 60 degrees. That'll give us 120. From there, I can divide both sides by 3 to get my x. And my x is 40 degrees. That means the value of our x is 40 degrees. So that's the last question we'll be solving on this theorem. These two theorems I will just prove. And if you have not watched the previous videos on the solution of these two theorems, please go back to the two previous videos and watch other solution questions that we have solved. And on the screen right now, you are having two questions that you have to attempt on your own. If you have gone this through this training, yeah, you should be able to solve these two questions. The first one saying figure one, you have to find angle EAD. Angle EAD, this is this angle that is here. And the second in figure two, you have to find angle BXD. Angle BXD. That's it, this angle that is marked there, given all these angles, this angle, 102 and 47 for this figure. So thank you for listening to this. Thank you for watching today's video. You are doing a great job, and we have been soliciting for help for those that love good things, and that you have been following us off since the beginning session of these channels for help to get some items so that you can take these channels to the next level. We have the mindset of helping the younger generations in understanding the concept or in the mathematics, all the topics in mathematics. And please help us to subscribe to these channels, like the video, share the videos, and please do subscribe. It's very important to us. And as you do so, may the good Lord bless you. In the next video, we're talking about Monk theorem in circle geometry or circle theorem. So do have a wonderful day. Thank you for listening.